friends, followers, and fellow flightsimmers. Welcome back to another video. And this time, I will be explaining my window layout and my settings in Little Navmap. Actually, this was a question asked after I published my first video about Little Navmap, and a big shout out to Jay-Z. He asked the question and wanted to learn how I set up my window layout and what options I use in Little Navmap. So this is going to be a very short video where I explain my own setup and how you can copy my setup and use the same settings as I do if you like to do that. I hope this helps some of you. Before I dive into the video, while you are here, please consider hitting that subscribe button and hitting the bell to get notified for future videos. This helps tremendously and fuels me for more videos. Thanks a lot for those of you who already subscribed to the channel. I appreciate you guys a lot. And without further ado, let's jump into the video. As you see, I only have the map on my Little Navmap screen and nothing else. And we will set this up from scratch like how I use it. First option I use is the search option. You can dock or undock the window using this little icon here. And this will give you the airports, navies, procedures, user waypoints for you to search. If you want to shorten this list, there is a drop-down box here and you can get rid of the user waypoints and it will not be visible anymore. Same for online clients, online centers, online server. You can filter this and make it look like what you want to see, or feel, you know, reduce the options so that you have what you need and nothing more. The second option I use is the flight planning dock window. This is this little icon here. And this gives you the option for your flight plan, like we discussed in the last video. Gives your waypoints, departure and destination airport. And same thing applies here too. You can add or remove fuel pool, add or remove tabs, and that will be visible for you. Like the fuel report, current performance. For these to work, you have to have an aircraft performance file within the Little Navmap. And then when you fly in Little Navmap, when you leave the window open, it will calculate the performance of the aircraft and then you can save it for future use. This way, it can calculate your top of descent a little bit more accurately. The third option I use is the info or information dock. This gives you information about the airports, including the ones in your flight plan. If I double click, you will see the information about the airport. You get the navets close to the airport, airspaces, if there are any around the airport that you selected, user points to. Same thing applies here. You can remove some of the options that you don't need. And I barely use airspaces, so let me fix that while I'm here. These two are the most common ones I use. I accidentally turned it off, so you can bring it back if that happens to you as well. If you close it by mistake, you can open here and put it back to where it was and then drag and drop to slide it to the location you want. So this is the screen layout I am using. There is another option that I used to use, but I stopped using it because it takes up too much real estate on the screen. And that is this vertical profile or elevation profile of the flight plan. Again, for this to work properly, you have to have an aircraft performance file. Otherwise, this type of descent calculation will not be accurate. And you also need to enter your flight plan, cruising altitude for your flight plan for this to work. But again, as I said, this takes up too much space on my screen and for me, it doesn't provide any valuable information. Therefore, I don't use this window and undock this. You can also have a legend, but I'm not using that too. So those are the screen layout options. When it comes to the map, I use OpenStreetMap, sometimes OpenTopoMap if I'm flying VFR to see the elevation profile around the airports. So this is up to you. There is also a cartographic map as well, but I usually stay on OpenStreetMap. Top of the bar, the only thing here I use is the center simulator on center the map on the aircraft, and then the airports, as well as VORs, NDBs, waypoints, and ILS feathers. I don't use the airways. The flight plan, this is going to show your flight plan on the map. This is, you also can add the missed approach legs. If you have a procedure, that will be displayed here too. Like, you know, if I go to my destination airport and add a procedure, such as arrival procedures, approach, and you have a lot of approaches. We'll select one of them, and you will see that approach on the window too. And as you see, the missed approach is also drawn on the map. So that's sometimes handy if you are flying with an airliner or an IFR flight and using instruments to land. So this is one of them as well. And you can right click this and insert the approach into your flight plan routing. And then you will have that. You will have that entered or added to your flight plan, like so. So now we have a procedure or IFR approach into this airport. The other options here, simulator position, or like the other aircraft in the sim. This is your flight plan trail. AI multiplayer apps, boats. You can even display the boats in Microsoft Flight Simulator in the map. It detects those, and that's pretty much it. This is what I wanted to share, and as I said, this is a very short video of little Navmap. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope this helps some of you to understand little Navmap a little bit more. And thanks for being here with me today, and I'll be seeing you in the next video.